A refir means a please.
What's he gonna say?
Hey, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to it. You're watching Coffee and Comedy with myself, Rezah, taking you till the hour of 10:30 p.m. So we're gonna be a liquor time with you, a liquor Ricky, for the next 30 minutes or so. We are so happy that you joined us every week religiously right here on Cape Town TV channel 263, on DSTV and channel 32 on the free-to-air platform. Exciting news is that soon we will be launching an online platform such as your Netflix and your Showmax, whatever the case may be, where you can actually then watch the repeats of these shows, your favorite shows on Cape Town TV, on there. So make sure you stick around and find out more about that actually. Let's get straight into it. When it comes to couples, there are always arguments. Nothing is always green and nothing is always perfect. And normally with young couples, you are always fighting about likes, comments, and all of this is on your social media, and this is how it normally goes down.
If you look so, then you are getting quiet for something. Quiet! You really ask me why I'm quiet. You per me wanna be moila. You ask me why I'm quiet. Why you quiet? Now why you quiet? Why you quiet? Why must I permit see your name under other kind's photos? Oh, yo, my bro, a kindness. Is it that you are? Then you don't like the photo, you want to react the photo. Per me see your name there under there. No, my bro, it's the photo. I was just liking the time for this. If you want to be unfaithful or your loyalty doesn't have, where do that now come in? Now why must you say that, man? Why must you? Shh, you can like a picture, but don't need to act on it. Understand? Like, I can like your brassel, but I don't need to act on it. On like this over a photo that I like. No, don't come with just a photo, my bro. No. Every time I must scroll, then your name must be unknown, my bro. You was liking what you seen. Don't you like what you see, y'all? Scroll and then I like it. It doesn't mean anything. I don't care what you say, my bro. I don't care, man. I like the man's photos. Go like the man's photos. Go like them. Then I will like their photos. I will go like all the photos. I'll even comment on their photos. Fine. Now we can do that. You just like their pictures and I like the goodness pictures. And fine, then we do that. Settled. No, we can do that. We can do that, my bro. We can do that. You think we can do? I'm gonna go. Yeah. You like it. Like their photos. Most wanna like the goodness photos, no? Now I will start liking the man's photos. Yes, I will start liking it. I will like. Oh, yeah, I'll see myself. Chatting toxic you, toxic man. I have conversations with them under the comments, my bro. Then you must come get quiet, no? You must come get quiet. You are toxic, Sinja. You toxic. Yeah. Cool. Away. Away. You're not liking the man. Show me you like the man.
Oh, I know too many of those. I was driving already once. And then I was just looking like, if you drive, you need to look where you're driving. And then I was told, you can must give her a love. No, stop the car, I will walk, you can give her a love. You must like what you see. So I know too well about that. One thing that I don't know is how to Shazam a song that's in your head. Like, you know the song, but you don't remember where you heard it. So now you try to hum it to Shazam. But Shazam don't speak your language. And then it normally goes down like this.
I didn't mean it when I said I didn't love you so. I should've hung on tight, I never should've let you go. And I was stupid, I was foolish, I was selfish, I was lying to myself.
Send! Shazam's like, no, we don't see it. And then a serious question for all Coffee and Comedy female viewers. Are you tired of looking for man? Do you need man in your life? Do you need a real man? Well, maybe the next ad will show you how to get the real man.
Dame, soek jy man? Of sukkel jy om man te kry? Wel, ek het die perfekte ding vir jou. Try die MKM. Mans kom nou. Soos in die mans moet nou kom.
Menta, nou wanneer gaan jy nou vir jou om man kry? Nee, wag. Van wanneer soek ek 'n man, die mans kon na my toe.
Girls, don't be like Samantha. Sy weet seker nie man. Draai die MKN. Mans kom nou. Die MKN is 'n spesiale gesigwassery. So, die manier hoe jy hom kan breek is, jy vat net 'n bietjie van dit. Soos byvoorbeeld, jy vat 'n bietjie van dit. Jy sien, wit. Smeer hom in. Vryf hom in. En dan sal die mans na jou toe kom soos warme pitboele wat 'n styk jag.
Die man sal na jou toe kom soos warme pitboele wat 'n styk jag. Oh, and I love it. Woo, yes! Yes, I need that. After the break, we are joined by King Klutch, the one and only guy from Mitchell's Plain. After 56 songs, no features, 5 mixtapes, and his music is available on all platforms, he is here and he is back to tell us what he has been up to. See you now. Don't go too far. Mans kom nou. You are still watching Coffee and Comedy with myself, Rezah Forbes, and our guest for this evening is the one and only King Klutch, all the way from Mitchell's Plain. He released his first song in 2019 called Fergie, 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 Fergie. Hey! And from there, this brah has been hot and is being chased like pitbulle achter warme steaks. King Klutch, you back, man. You were yes, with sir. Us last season.
Yes, sir.
You
yes,
back
sir.
This season. It's yes, so nice to have
very
you
back. Very happy to be back. We're
watching you. We watched you from last season. And when I mean watching, we're seeing what you're doing on social media. We're seeing your gigs, the things that you're doing.
Yeah.
How would you say you have grown from last season to this season?
Well, now I celebrate getting booked. By getting booked again.
Wow! So, yeah, look at that.
That's what I've been doing. That's dope. Really putting in a lot of work, day and night, sleeping 4 hours every day of the week, you know, doing like literally the most.
Crazy.
I got my team behind me, and we really like, you know, sacrificing a lot to be in the position that we are in right now. So I think I deserve it, man. I feel like I deserve it.
You know, I think you deserve it. We all deserve it if we put in the hard work.
Correct,
and it actually, it happens.
Materializing. And
exactly. And you have so much on your plate, you know, pushing new music and everything. Correct. But the main thing that's on your plate now that keeps you on your toes between the music and everything.
Correct.
Is because last time you were single.
Are we going there?
And this time it's like, because now you need to balance. Like,
accommodate, yeah.
Yeah,
that's
you know
the,
what I'm saying?
Right
J-Bow rap, J-Bow leave a mic. How are you balancing life now? Because it's not only that, it's the COVID-19 pandemic.
Correct.
As well.
Correct, yeah.
You can't just go out and perform as you want to, you know. There kind of needs to be that safety protocol in place as well. And also with the levels, it's up and down. You don't know if it's going to... How are you handling all of this?
Well, I think it's an exceptionally smart question. Personally, for me, I don't think COVID is an excuse. I don't think the pandemic is an excuse. Maybe when it comes to the events or things like that.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that you can utilize that time effectively to do something else, you know, that could amount to the same effectivity of that. You know, there is always something that you can do. There is no limitation.
100%.
I take it, you know, maybe as it is a knock. But that doesn't, you know, people are performing live and then people are doing shows that, you know, book me on Quicket, you know, or something like that, you know. So there's always a way, man. Where there's a will, there's a way. So 100%. There's no excuse.
And I agree with it, with you in that aspect. But I have to admit that the way the theatres and events organizers and artists are moving now is somewhat different because we are acquiring a new skill now. And that is how to kind of stay relevant through... Yeah. Pandemics and through everything that's happening. What do you think the future of the entertainment industry, not just in South Africa, but in the whole world, it's going to be like accommodating pandemics, accommodating certain things? Because I think it opened up our eyes. We're like, oh, nothing can go wrong. And the music's going to be here forever and the show's going to be here forever. And then boom. No one's getting booked for like, because I wasn't on stage for 2 years.
Oh, goodness.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So it's crazy. And I'm only going on stage next week for the first time. So it's like breaking my virgin again. But that's not the thing. The thing is, what do you think the industry is going to be like for entertainment moving forward? how will artists and event organizers look at gigs moving forward now in terms of putting everything together?
Well, I think I know one thing is for sure is that COVID is definitely going to come to an end. The pandemic is definitely going to come to an end. We must all realize that. As per where event organizers is concerned, I'm very confident they want to make their money.
100%.
So they're going to do something about it. That is for 100%. Sure. I'm not an event organizer, so I can't tell you, you know. But as for me as an artist, I'm lucky to be in the position that I am. You know, exactly like you're saying, staying relevant. You know, you have social media, Instagram, your Facebook here and there. And in this pandemic, this is the time where people are mostly on their phones.
100%.
So social media is more like a tool where you can utilize, you know, to stay relevant. But with the gigs is concerned, it's not always that you're going to have 10 gigs, you know, it's not easy unless you're that guy and they really decide, yo, I need this guy, he's going to bring people, you know, if I book this guy, he's going to bring about 500 fans to come.
And that's
here,
the thing,
you know?
they're booking the A-listers.
Yes.
They're getting money and, you know, the local artists are suffering.
Correct.
But how do we change that narrative? Because I think this was a question now that a lot of artists ask themselves is that what makes me so different to the A-listers? Because as hard as he works, I'm working just as hard, whether my gig is local, whatever the case may be. How do we change the narrative so that all artists are equal? Because the thing is this, and I can tell you this sort of fact, if you go to the States, you will see that people are making a living off entertainment and they're not on our TVs and they're not in Hollywood, but they are performing in Las Vegas and they're performing there and they're getting booked and they can survive.
I'm aware.
But that is something you can't even survive as an A-lister in South Africa because you're A-lister but all your gigs are gone. There's no thing such as protection packages in place. People are playing your songs on the radio and you don't even get paid for that royalties. And that happens to A-listers. I'm not only talking about you guys.
Yeah.
This happens to A-listers as well. But in America, if they play 30 seconds of your song, you're getting paid for it. Whatever happens with you as an artist, the royalties in there, everything. So how do we make the narrative, change the narrative, saying that, listen, in South Africa, artists are artists. Because without me, you can't exist.
Absolutely.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Personally, I think we're changing the narrative is concern is that, you know, I was just telling somebody off air now is that, you know, especially for our colored people, you know, the people, they like to complain, like, oh, there's no opportunity, the opportunity is there, but it's sitting. You're not taking the opportunity, you're not sacrificing, you're not doing what you need to be doing. So as per changing the narrative is concerned, my perspective on that would basically be as local artists compared to the A-listers, I would say there is A-listers out there that is giving opportunities to local artists, you know. And I personally think my advice would be for local artists to change that narrative would basically be to be a product that you're not going to find everywhere. You see right now the music industry is diverging away from hip-hop and you see the Ama Piano is coming.
It's coming.
I don't know if you know Focalistic, that guy, he came into my understanding, he came as a rapper, he's now an Ama Piano rapper, you know. So the development is very important, but I personally think is that if you stay hungry, you stay committed, you stay determined, if you really want this, you're going to get it.
100%, and I agree
really
with you.
If you want it, you're going to get
it. And you really wanted it because you got 56
songs,
no features.
Right. 56 songs, 5 mixtapes with no features on all platforms on the world. That's besides my singles, besides, you know, a lot of other things.
Crazy. What is this no feature business now? Because you're making me ask, like, don't you like the other brasa?
No, it's not to do with any other artist. It's a personal thing, to be honest, you know, because on the come up, I want people to understand and get the point here that
it was solely you.
Exactly, you know, and it's my music and the versatility to come, to be consistent, to have 56 different approaches to 56 different beats. Where I come from, they would say, I will gedoen wees.
I will gedoen wees.
As facts right there, straight up. So,
that's crazy. What is King Klutch achieving in the future? What is King Klutch setting out for himself to make sure that he's going to be at the top of his game?
Consistency, staying hungry. I think personally people is starting now to get the idea like, yo, you need to pay attention now. Here's somebody out here that is really you can see the passion in his eyes, you know. So as per what, like, what I have coming forward for me, as you can see, we live, we going on the radio, we dropping the music videos, there's a whole lot of collaborations coming. Now I can do the collaborations, I can do the features.
The thing is, you drop music videos like every week almost, like I can't even keep up. It's so crazy, how do you keep up with everything?
I'll be very honest, like, I really want this, man. Like, I really, really want this. So, like I said, there's no excuse, you know, I really put, and this is where staying relevant comes in. You know, it's the consistency. It's the consistency. You can have 50k followers, but you're not dropping anything. I can have 1,500 followers.
You're dropping every week.
But I got 50,000, whatever the case may be. You know,
it's crazy.
So, yeah, like I said, there's no excuse, man.
There's no excuse. You know? King Klutch, no, ladies and gentlemen, keep doing what you're doing. We're very proud of you. I'm very proud of you. I know we speak whenever we can, and it's always dope talking to you and having you on the show as well. We're gonna take a quick ad break. When we come back, dad jokes to the Lani. See you now. Ah, man, it's Coffee and Comedy with Rezah Forbes. Our guest this evening is the one and only King Klutch. As I even let it down, Rocky's back this season. And I'm challenging him in a game called Dad Jokes Try Not to Laugh. Okay, Josh, remind us how it works.
Okay, so with dad jokes, basically there's going to be a bunch of dad jokes. Mm-hmm. You guys are going to read it to one another. And whoever laughs or smiles or grins loses.
Okay. So and if you laugh at your own jokes, you lose.
Yes.
Okay. Oh, okay.
So I'll start.
Okay.
Are you ready with your poker face?
Wait, 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 give me
a Okay. Okay. So the guy who stole my diary just died. My thoughts are with his family. I get it.
I'm happy I don't.
It's tough if they don't get it. Oh yes, that's my point. You can't know. Okay, but... Read it out. That's 1-0 already.
I asked my date to meet me at the gym, but she never showed up. I guess the two of us aren't working out. Aren't going to work out. So, as deep.
I'll keep my word because I have my point already. What do you call it when James Bond takes a bath? Bubble 07.
Nah. Let's see. What do you call a fake noodle and impasta? That's one.
Impasta! This impasta right here! Okay, I get it. One.
Yeah.
What's brown and sticky? A stick.
Nah.
Joshua,
should I claim a point here?
No, he's making me laugh.
No, then I can't.
Okay,
2-1. What's an astronaut? What's an astronaut's favorite part of the computer? The space bar.
Space bar. I get it. 3-1.
Okay.
Nah, you can't win me so.
I'm leading.
Nah, you can't win me so. Do you know what Braille is?
Yeah. For the blind people, right?
They read.
Yeah, with their fingers.
I'm reading a horror story in Braille. Something bad is going to happen. I can just feel it.
I get it.
Are you smiling there?
No, I'm not.
Like, I feel it coming. Okay, so it's 3-2.
Yeah.
Okay, okay.
Yeah, it's actually so much fun, huh? Nice.
That's 3-3. No. That's 3-3.
What do you call a toothless bee? A gummy bee.
Okay.
Oh my word.
Oh, that was a good one. Yeah. I didn't expect that. So it's 4-3.
Yeah.
Why are skeletons so calm? Because nothing gets under their skin. Don't be fanaposa. You doing all the laughing. Okay. 4-3 still.
You leading.
Okay. We still have a couple of minutes, yeah?
What did the police officer say to his belly button? You're under a vest.
Okay. So it's 1.1 point. So it's 5-4.
5-4. Okay, cool.
Okay. I can't let you win. You're under a vest. What does a lemon say when it answers the phone? Hello. You can go last one for the win. You were strong there. You were strong there. I saw that. Last one for the win.
I wasn't close to my father when he died, which is lucky because he stepped on a landmine.
I got it. But I'm strong. Why are you laughing? He made me laugh.
Okay, I'll give you another one.
No, you win the game. Thank you so much for that. King Klutch, thank you so much for coming through the Coffin Comedy Headquarters. It's been dope having you here. Can't wait to see you perform right now. Same time, same place, next week, 10 p.m. till 10:30, every Friday right here on Cape Town TV. King Klutch, do your ding, bruh. Try to get you under my pressure. I talk to him. I've been trying. But like this. Get you under my pressure. Yeah. Hard just turned purple, I'm not going worldwide, bro, I'm going universal. Since bitches playing primary, I was jumping hurdles. Now I do athletics on his tracks. I inspire all these niggas to the point they wanna rap. Go to Facebook, then you look at my reacts. Even my ex hit me up saying that she want me back. Look, La Pica Jacobs will have a problem. And if she has one, then I'ma solve them. Put this pin down your throat, better hope that it's dissolving. Seeing that you know that I kill it often. Pardon. So much lines I'm even writing in my margins. Look. I told my team sometimes I really lose hope. How do I get my songs playing there on good hope? When Reddy D's not somebody that you know, even though I've been twice on the Reddy D show. And that's facts. 5 mixtapes, no features, facts. 56 songs, all platforms, facts. 2 damn fly, no visas, facts.
I can't sing, but
I try.
Clutch Control Studio.
Got the homies with me. This is what we do.
They like, can you tell us how we feels? We never knew Ishmael signed a record deal. We didn't thought you're independent still. I'm like, of course, told the label just to cancel a contract. This is not a game, but they talking Mortal Kombat. Fake niggas, shh, KG, I'm not on that. Take a look at what ambitions do with MT. No one told me what it took to be an MC. Now I'm going high like I'm dropping MD. I heard you the doctor, stick it to the party with the MT.
You always seem to get your priority straight. Every weekend when I look in the new different set, holding on the bottle like it's gonna run away. I see you better when I'm looking with closed eyes. Visions of Riyadh coupling me a cosign. People ask me, do I really write my own lines? My notepad worth more than a gold mine. I don't need a gun just so I can blow minds. Just pass me the mic and it's go time. This is not a pun, bro, this is a clothesline. I figured it out, same it always almost like SARS. Like I paid tax just to spit bars. Well, I'm signed to myself, so I'm the man in charge. I am owning my art, I am from it just plain, but it comes from the heart. If it wasn't for the lily, then this number wouldn't start. You said believe in yourself, it's a walk in the park. Now it's a walk in the park, nigga. WhatsApps out of the UK. They're like, yo, King Klutch, what do you say? Let's do a song crunch time like Moosley. They know I'm a most deaf and a Lupe. Ever since an embryo, before Suarez spot to Atletico, I knew that I'd be ballin' like a Marco Asensio. Drop 56 songs and not one of them is identical. I had no more list, but the list could go on. Dropping lyrical spirit bombs, call me Gohan. Some are ahead, cause I said go so long. I just keep the ball rolling, I apply it all on. My money looking like Michael Phelps. Circle so small, team talk with myself. Cape Town underground, I got the heavyweight belt, nigga. What's up? Remember the name, nigga.
Find me on Instagram, King Klutch CPT. Find me on Facebook, King Klutch CPT. You know what's good, what's happening. Yes. Shout out to Rezah Forbes. Yes. Coffee and comedy, you know how we do this. Ain't Cape no Town's on the come up. You go like
number
this.
Number 785.